The new candidature process is excellent. And the word, I think, which comes to mind is collaboration. And the way the IOC has approached this and the way that obviously it worked well for us is that collaboration. So working together to come up with the best way of hosting a Games here in Brisbane. Obviously, you still have to provide all the information, you still have to provide all the guarantees, all those very important requirements.
Under the new norm, there's a period where interested cities in becoming a candidature can embark on continuous dialogue with the IOC, and that's when the IOC Games and Sports and other departments are available to give advice, and that was very much taken up by the Brisbane candidacy.
I think that the other important aspect of it is it obviously saves a lot of money, which is important, and it also saves a lot of time. You use the knowledge of the IOC to help the host city or the host state, in our case, to be able to put together a really good proposal. It goes back to the line that the IOC uses, that the change is that instead of making the city fit the Games will fit the city. So using Brisbane and South East Queensland's settings, venues, facilities, and moulding that to come up with a great candidature for the Olympic Games of 2032.
I'm confident that the Games will leave a very positive legacy for the people of Southeast Queensland, for Queensland and all of Australia. They'll leave a legacy in sport. They'll leave a legacy in how we address the climate issues that are so very important. They'll leave a legacy in greater recognition of our First Nations people. And they will ensure that more people, athletes or children, right through to mature age athletes, are participating in sport, and we'll have a healthier and a far happier society. So there's a lot that we're going to achieve, and we will achieve it in Brisbane.
It's very important to understand your own backyard, the venues and facilities that you have, how you're going to go about it, and most importantly, together. Brisbane 2032 candidature did was bring together the Commonwealth Government of Australia, the Queensland Government, the Brisbane City Council and other local councils, the National Olympic Committee ourselves, and the Paralympic Committee as well. And so it was that together moment that made it possible. And I think the National Olympic Committee of any country can play a really good role in bringing all the parties together for the benefit of their candidature for an Olympic Games, whether it be summer, winter or youth.
Paralympics Australia and Paralympians were involved in developing the plan and creating the vision for Brisbane 2032. One of the most powerful commitments made in this bid is that 500,000 people with a disability who currently have no access to sporting facilities, who want access to sporting facilities, will get that opportunity. They're going to get that opportunity in the next 10 years before the Games even start. And that's a commitment. That's not an aspiration. That's a commitment of every Games partner. So what we say to other NPCs who are contemplating a bid for Games is the key message is get involved as early as you can. Be confident that there is a role for you to play very early on in the process, and that there is so much that could be capitalised on by being part of the early stages of forming that vision. The athlete experience for Paralympians in Brisbane 2032 is going to be one of welcoming, one of familiarity, one of ease of access. It is going to be seamless, absolutely seamless. It's going to bring to bear all the learnings of past Games. It's going to build upon all the wonderful accessibility that there is in Southeast Queensland at the moment and make it such a smooth and welcoming environment that makes their Games experience one that allows them to focus entirely on their performance. One of the key benefits that we've identified is not that the Games themselves will be a catalyst for change, but the lead into the Games provide an incredible catalyst, an accelerant to change that's already happening within society. So the change that's happening around inclusion, the change that's happening around accessibility, people identify with these challenges, but the Games provides an enormous impetus to accelerate that change and deliver benefits earlier and on a much broader scale.